Hi everyone, my name is Manisha and welcome back to my channel. So today's reading is for Scorpio Sun Sign and for the week 10th May to 17th May. I have already drawn the cards for you, so let's see what this week gonna bring to you. So this is the energy that you are bringing to this particular week. That means commencement of the week. You are working hard. I mean, definitely. Just look at the Pentacles card. You are working hard. You are continuously working hard to achieve things in your life, to achieve your aim, your ambition in your life. But somehow you're very scared whether you'll be able to achieve what you're dreaming of or not. You're scared that people will create a lot of problem in your path, or maybe, you know, people around you are not at all very trustworthy. You are not able to trust, but somehow this is also giving me an impression that whatever the reason which is making you, you know, scared of all these people, it's useless. I mean, they're not gonna harm you. They cannot, in fact. They cannot. It's more like in your head that you're continuously getting feared, or, you know, creating this blockage in your success path. So try to change your focus from getting, you know, feared or feeling that these people are against you or they can create a problem. No, it's not like that. Try to mingle with them in a different way, so that you can understand who they are, what they want. And I guess there is it's not necessary to fight with them. I mean, there are thousands of ways to deal with other people, and I guess you should do this. So this is the kind of energy you're gonna bring to this week. You're a little confused. You're not happy with the people around you. You feel that they are not very trustworthy, or they are somehow competing with you, trying to put you down or something like this. But at the same time, you're working very hard for your dreams and ambition, which is something good. Now what this week gonna bring? Okay. Here I told you what energy you're gonna bring to this week. You're fearful. You're not very confident that you will be able to handle all this work or not, or whatever opportunities are coming to your way, or whatever work you are having right now in your hand. You're confused at whether, you know, things will fall into the right place or not, whether you'll be able to come up as a leader or not, whether you'll be able to, you know, get successful in all these ventures or not. And I guess because of this feeling of distrust, this feeling of not able to trust people around you, gonna create a lot of issues. Because if you present yourself as a competition in front of someone else, then they will definitely consider you as in competition. But if you put your personality, if you put yourself as a friend, as someone who's there to help rather than to compete with them, then they will consider you as friend and not an enemy, or not at all as in competition. So this is completely in your hand. If you go with this energy, you're gonna face a lot of opposition. Definitely these people will try to create issues for you, because you're putting up a very hard face in front of them, and this is the reason why they will start considering you as a competition, as someone who's not, you know, very friendly. So to actually avoid all these issues, to actually avoid such kind of energy in your life, you can change the way you're presenting yourself in front of them. Or even if you're considering them as your competition, try to find different ways, try to find different paths so that you can deal with them in a more calmer way as comparison to very aggressively. And here is the advice for you. Knowledge and action. Knowledge is useless if there is no action, and action is even more dangerous if it's taken without any knowledge. So concentrate on these two things if you really wanted to deal with all the competition around you, all the people around you with whom you're supposed to work or you're supposed to compete. So keep in your mind, knowledge and action both should come together. Don't take any action without knowing the whole situation. Sometimes we are so much immersed in our own thought that we just take actions without knowing this other part of the story. So don't take any action without knowing everything. Maybe there is something which is hidden from you. So try to find out everything and then take your action. Similarly, if you're having any kind of knowledge, then share it. Share it with people who are around you. You're gonna gain from this. There's nothing that you can lose by helping other people. So yeah, this was a glimpse of next week. Thank you so much for watching my video. Please do subscribe my channel. And if you're interested in monthly reading, then please do check out my playlist. I have already done May and June reading. So yeah, thank you. Have a nice day. Bye-bye.